Today on BRTV Investigates, it's time to take a slightly different approach to lighting our reef tanks with the AI Prime. Hi, Ryan, your host of BRTV Investigates, a weekly YouTube series which explores popular reefing theories, products, methods, and what the manuals are missing with a focus on putting them to the test, and then give away much of what we test at the end. This week, we're giving away a handful of these AI Primes away for free. The cool thing about the AI line is the scalability based on the needs for your tank, meaning they have the Hydra 52HD, which has 4 pucks, the 26, which has 2 pucks, and now the AI Prime, which has a single puck. Well, a lot of reefers might use 2 Hydra 52s, which is 8 pucks on a 4-foot tank, then turn them down substantially to avoid hot spots. We're going to look at this from a totally different angle, and that's taking those same 8 pucks, or even 6, and then spread them out over a wider area to achieve a more even spread and reduce shadowing. Well, this isn't as cost effective. The dispersed lighting approach absolutely matches today's mindset to reefing, which is eliminate the spotlight approach, increase even coverage, and reduce shadowing. Diving right into it, we're gonna look at coral health factors with providing adequate PAR, how the PAR is distributed, and spectrum. Our focus is always on SPS and higher demand corals when evaluating PAR, because almost any common reef tank lighting can provide the lower PAR required for LPS and lower light corals. The range that we're shooting for with SPS is between 250 and 350 in as much of the tank as possible. That range coming from our episode called How Much PAR for SPS, which dives into that question from all angles. We're gonna start with a single AI Prime on our 24-inch cube with all channels at 100% max, mounted 8 inches off the surface of the water, and then measure a 36-point grid at a depth of 6, 12, and 18 inches deep in the tank. Keep in mind the numbers are not gonna be super impressive because this single puck is not designed to put out extreme PAR numbers in a 2-foot by 2-foot area. At a depth of 6 inches in the tank and the center 4 inches, we're seeing an average PAR of 287, moving the measurement points out 4 inches in all sides to the center ring, an average of 178 PAR, and just 44 PAR in the outer ring. This is pretty close to what you should expect from a 55-watt LED with a compact single puck like this one. Moving down to a depth of 12 inches, the lens is now dispersing the light pretty well with an average of 155 in the center, 134, 4 inches outside that, and 89 in the outer ring. Now near the bottom at a depth of 18 inches, the lens and distribution system is what I would call near perfect performance with 100 PAR in the center, 104 in the middle ring, and 101 in the outside ring. The back of the tank being a bit lower because it's painted black. Now this was with all channels at 100%, not many people are gonna run them that way. Since they don't really give any direct instructions on the best settings for actual use, we did our best using the spectrometer to emulate Ecotec's AB Plus spectrum that they've been using in their coral labs. I'm not sure it's perfect, but this is the program we developed, and I think it turned out pretty close to Ecotec's AB Plus spectrum mix. This had the UV set at 119%, violet at 116%, royal blue at 79%, blue at 80%, green at 4%, red at 4%, and cool white at 19%. You'll notice that the top two are set at over 100%, which might seem odd, but that's one of the benefits of AI's HD system. If you underdrive some channels, it allows you to divert the power to other channels, which is kind of a neat feature. So repeating the same test with the new settings, the PAR will be significantly lower, but a bit closer to some settings reefers will actually use. If you want to get additional PAR, you can certainly increase some of the other channels. Looking at a depth of 6 inches, the PAR in the center 4 inches is 197, 4 inches outside that 113, and the outer ring an average of 27 PAR. Overall, this represents about a 35% drop in PAR. Moving down to 12 inches deep, there's now a center 4-inch average of 104, dropping to 91, 4 inches outside that, and an average of 61 on the outer edges. Lastly, at a depth of 18 inches in the tank, that same ultra-flat distribution is 71 in the center, 68 in the middle ring, and 63 in the outer ring. All in all, I think you could run an SPS tank on these as long as it was small, like a 12-inch cube, or a pair on something like a Nuvo 20. But honestly, I think a lot of reefers might be surprised by how well a single low-cost light like this could do in a 2-foot cube as long as the only goal was an LPS tank. Might be visually a bit dim, but still a nice low-cost method of lighting a reef tank. Keep in mind Ecotec's Coral Lab results indicated reef wholesale shoots for a range of 40 to 75 PAR for LPS, which is pretty darn low. So moving on to distribution of light using multiple light sources in a larger tank with our 4-foot 120 gallon, We're going to look at three different installs, an install of 4 primes straight across, a grid of 6 primes, and a grid of 8 primes. I know 8 primes sounds like a lot, but keep in mind, this is essentially just 2 Hydra 52s split up into individual procs and then spread out over the tank more evenly. For all these, we're going to use that AB Plus program we developed because it's probably closer to what an actual user would use. So note, you could increase these numbers by as much as 35% if you wanted to turn up the other channels. So starting with 4 primes in line, we're seeing a center 4-inch by 24-inch average of 290 par, moving the measurements out 4 inches in all directions to that middle ring, an average of 177 par, and then 67 par in the outer edges at the top of the tank. Moving down to 12 inches deep in the tank, we're seeing 234 par in the center of the tank, 171 in the middle ring, and 117 par on the outer edges. You'll note the distribution from left to right is much more even in this configuration because of the overlap between the light sources. However, the front to back is less even and a more significant fall off. Then dropping to the bottom of the tank, pretty flat, even distribution of 179 par in the center, 152 in the middle ring, and an average of 135 par on the outside edges of the tank. All in all, I would certainly say this puck inline configuration is a better solution than a single Hydra 52. Even though it does cost a bit more, you can save a bit of money and go with 2 Hydra 52s, but the distribution of light would be less even. I do think this is an awesome solution for an LPS tank, and you might even want to turn it down a bit. It's also likely an adequate solution for a mix to LPS and SPS tank, as long as the SPS are positioned well in the tank. Now changing things up a bit and looking for even distribution from front to back and get a bit better coverage. With 6 primes, again, it sounds like a lot, but it's just 1.5 Hydra 52s. Starting with the depth of 6 inches, you can already see the performance on the front of the tank is much higher. But in some ways, we traded increased performance on the front and back of the tank for decreased performance on the sides. We've now seen an average of 345 in the center of the tank, 268 4 inches outside that, and 140 on the outer edges. At 12 inches deep, the tank has pretty solid performance with 287 in the center of the tank, 220 in the middle ring, and 163 in the outer edges. However, most notably, there's lower par on the back and sides of the tank. At a depth of 18 inches, the 6 modules are now producing 231 in the center, 207 in the middle ring, and 194 on the outside. Again, sides and back being significantly dimmer than the front. To me, this hits a definition of a mixed tank lighting solution that's going to have a decent amount of well-placed SPS in a variety of areas in the tank. The spread, combined with most aquascapes, is going to provide a wide variety of visually predictable par ranges. Not only that, but with 6 independent light sources, we can create very localized higher and lower par areas for specific corals. Visually, you won't be able to see the difference, but we can hone the lighting to the coral's needs in ways we're just not able to do with other methods. Looking at the 8-prime install, I can tell you right now, this would be my preference over 2 Hydra 52s in almost all common tank installs, but I might consider 4 Hydra 26s as well, which are all, again, the same amount of pucks, just dispersed differently. With 8 primes, we essentially have 1 prime covering every square foot of the tank, which feels about right, almost certainly going to provide pretty even coverage, but more importantly, eliminate a lot of the shadowing effects, which are so problematic for large colony SPS dominant tanks. Starting at a depth of 6 inches, it's pretty easy to see the distribution of light is much smoother with 444 in the center, 346 in the middle ring, and 194 in the outer edges. This is difficult to achieve at this height in the tank and a direct result of spreading the light sources out further. Moving down to a depth of 12 inches, continued results with 371 in the center, 295 in the middle ring, and 220 on the edges. This is right in that perfect pocket for most SPS, and light coming from virtually every angle. And at the bottom of the tank, we're seeing 301 in the center, 274 in the middle ring, and 231 in the outside edges of the bottom of the tank. I have to say, this is approaching near ideal performance for the modular format and a really solid solution for a wall-to-wall SPS tank. It still isn't what I would call inexpensive, but it's about the same cost as some other popular solutions like 2 Radeon XR30 Pros with the Reef Link. This installation will almost certainly provide better results as well. Again, these 8 independent modules allow for adjustments in zoning. It's very possible that the back of the tank where the rock work is positioning the corals high, you might want to create a zone with the modules turned down to achieve that 250 to 350 in the top half of the tank. However, in the front of the tank where the corals are almost certainly further from the light, we might want to run that AB Plus program at max to reach the 250 to 350 at the bottom of the tank. I fully realize this zoning concept sounds pretty geeky and beyond what most reefers are going to implement, but I think it's pretty awesome, and I know for sure I would like to do something like that on the 160. Fact is, on the right side, the corals are just further from the light source than they are on the left side, and I can't help but want to optimize for that. Moving on to Spectrum, I don't think many people will be overly surprised. The Spectrum offering is fairly similar to the Radions because they are sister companies with fairly similar approaches to reef tank lighting, but there are some subtle differences. The AI Prime has just a bit more focus on that 460 to 470 range and a little less on the 400 to 430 range. Overall, just a small shift to the right. Looking at each channel individually, the white channel has a strong peak around 440 and fills in the fuller spectrum many reefers will use to make the tank look a bit more natural. The near UV channel peaks around 410, violet 415, royal blue 450, blue at 470, green at 515, and the red right at 660. But looking at the blended spectrum, we are seeing the important coverage at the 430 and 660 peaks for chlorophyll A, solid peak near 450 for important chlorophyll C, and a solid representation in the 400 to 500 range important to carotenoids. There's no question, this light was designed to support corals. Now looking at how this light blends the individual spectrums cohesively into a single uniform spectrum, starting with static spectrum in air, with the light 19 inches above the sensor from 9 different points, which is a good indication of proper distribution of the individual colors and lens design. You can see here there are some spectrum differences at each point, but they're not dramatic, not something that I'd be concerned about. It's not surprising the puck design seems to distribute the light fairly well. Moving on to the dynamic spectrum, which is measuring how the lenses interact with the surface of the water by adding a pump to break the surface tension and then measuring the underneath the tank. You can see that there are some fairly significant changes in spectrum, creating spectrum hotspots. However, this is something that we are seeing with almost every LED module that we've tested so far that uses an array of individual lenses or no lens at all. Well, visually, the spectrums seem to be blended fairly well. The measurable results are different. It's actually something that you can see with the naked eye in some cases, evident by the identifiable colors in the sand or back of the tank. So overall, there's no question the AI Prime can grow corals. I think the single puck may have been originally designed for smaller tanks, but for more advanced applications, the use on larger tanks can be pretty darn impressive. The spread, intensity, and spectrum are amongst the best options currently out there. Moving on to visual appeal options with color pop, contrast, sense of depth, shimmer, dimming, lunar lights, and physical appeal, I'm not going to spend a ton of time on this because in this regard, it performs as well or better than many of the other modular light forms out there. The Spectrum offering is fully capable of bringing out and tuning color representation of basically any coral. Again, slightly less violet than the Radion, but very similar. The Puck modular design also creates a very similar contrasty feel in the tank with an interesting image and sense of depth. I will say this lens design seems to provide a better shimmer than some other similar designs and has a bit less disco-like appearance to it. However, almost all LEDs in this form factor are going to have some amount of disco or TV static effect. I'll note that when you have this many LED light sources spread out, shimmer lines begin to intersect a lot more, which has a muting effect and makes it appealing to most reefers. The Prime also has the ability to go all the way down to 1% on channels, which means that you can create lunar effects, which look really cool, can sometimes prevent fish from spooking and jumping out, and done properly can promote fish and even coral spawning. Lastly, light itself is ultra low profile, so it looks sharp in almost any installation. If you're considering a great mounting option is aluminum C-channel like we used here. It can be found at most hardware stores. Most reefers will prefer it painted black. We use Rust-Oleum flat black for projects like these. Next, we're going to look at the feature set list with mounting options, on and off-board controllability, intuitive modes, controller compatibility, build quality, and quiet operation. Mounting options are a big one for a lot of reefers, and beyond the do-it-yourself option I just mentioned, they have a tank mounting bracket, which is super easy to use, an ultra-low-profile, sharp-looking hanging kit, as well as the easy-to-use flex arm in a 12 and 18-inch length. So really no shortage of easy-to-use mounting methods for the tank. Controllability is one of the coolest features on the Prime and Hydra line. All you need to do is connect via your Wi-Fi on your computer, and it opens a window to control it. There's also a phone app with the direct Wi-Fi link. because it's scaled down to only what you need, I think this is one of the easiest solutions out there, and most people will be really happy with the ease of control and programming. However, there's no onboard controls, and those looking for help setting up the light are kind of out of luck as well. There's no intuitive programming modes to help you get the right spectrum settings. You're kind of on your own. So do your research and hope for the best. This is something I hope future generations of this light help more with. Owners deserve more guidance on how to properly use the product to achieve the desired results. On that note, it's also not compatible with popular aquarium controllers like the Apex. I don't think it's critical that the lights do that, but for those of you that want the entire ecosphere of their tanks monitored and controlled by something like the Apex, won't be able to do it. In relation to build quality and quiet operation, if you take one apart, it appears the heatsink and other components are engineered and designed well. Quality power supplies, and overall, a high perception of build quality. I also found the fan to be fairly quiet with almost no audible noise. All in all, I think the AI Prime can be used in a variety of smaller to larger tanks in some fairly surprising ways, and the wide array is a solid option I would consider using myself on an LED-only install. On to the best part of every video, we're giving away a handful of these Primes away this week, so click that link that just showed up, or head on over to the site and click on the specials and deals and then free stuff to sign up. I'm pretty curious if any of you have used Primes in a grid array like this or would consider doing so, so check out our Reef to Reef thread linked down below and then share your thoughts. As always, if you find what we're doing here valuable, give us a quick thumbs up and subscribe because we release new reefing videos all week long. See you next week with another episode of BRS TV Investigates.